Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to the midday edition of the Wake and Bake Show. And your host, Miss Green Jeans. Geechee Greens had a previous engagement, and it wasn't her fault that she couldn't be here, but I know she's here in spirit and heart. So let's go ahead and get the party started, shall we? Although a lot of y'all was hating yesterday, and I ain't gonna say no names, but congratulations to the New England Patriots for another successful win. The dynasty does continue. But if you read the title of the show today, it's Football City and CBD. What we gonna talk about today, yeah, we gonna talk about some football. We gonna talk about the game, which is one of the best games played, and y'all got to admit, if you're a lover of defense and you missed this game last night, you need to go ahead and catch that replay because you missed one hell of a game. We're gonna talk about that and more. We're gonna talk about also what is the meaning, for those who don't know what Football City is and why it's so important to us today here on the Wake and Bake Show. Are you ready for the show? If you ain't, get your dabs, your edibles, your medibles, your vapes, your pins, your dabs, your bottles, however you get down with the get down. Cause we finna roll up. Let's get it started. It's Monday, big baby. Here we go.
I'll roll up, I'll roll up, I'll roll up, shorty, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up, I'll roll up. It's your anniversary is near, and your man ain't acting right. So you packing your dummy air luggage up, calling my cell phone, trying to catch a flight. You know one thing straight, I'll be there, girl, whenever you call me. When you at home, that's your man. Soon as you land, you say it's all me. Cause shit ain't all G with him no more, you ain't entertained. Since I met you a couple months ago, you ain't been the same. Not saying I'm the richest man alive, but I'm in the game. As long as you keep it 100, I'ma spin this chain. Whenever you need me, whenever you want me, you know you can call me. I'll be there shortly, don't care what your friends say. Cause they don't know me, I can be your best friend. And you be my homie, I ain't gon' flex, I'm not gon' front. If I ball, then we all gon' stun. Send her my way, she ain't gotta hold up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up.
I try to stay out your business, but on the rig, it's so obvious. And if you keep fitting me in your plans of fucking up, your man's gonna get on us. That white sand surrounding us. He be handcuffing, he should work for them officers. If you rollin', I got a spot where I could put you on this medical and send you home doctored up. You wanna ride with me cause you say that he boring. Wake up, you rollin' weed, cooking eggs in the morning. Ain't scared to spend this money, I know I'll make more of it. First you was in the sky, now you say
whenever
you in
you
orbit.
Whenever you want me, you know you can call me. I'll be there shortly. Don't care what your friends say, cause they don't know me. I could be your best friend, and you be my homie. Go front, you know if I ball, then we all gon' stunt. Send her my way, she ain't gotta hold up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. No matter where I am, no matter where you are, I'll be there when it's over, baby. Cause I was there from the start. I'll be there shortly, don't care what your friends say, cause they don't know me. I could be your best friend, and you be my homie. I ain't gon' flex, I'm not gon' front. You know if I ball, then we all gon' stunt. Send her my way, she ain't gotta hold up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. Whenever you need me, whenever you want me, you know you can call me. I'll be there shortly, don't care what your friends say, cause they don't know me. I could be your best friend, and you be my homie. I ain't gon' flex, I'm not gon' front. If I ball, then we all gon' stunt. Send her my way, she ain't gotta hold up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up. I'll roll up, I'll roll up. Whenever you call, baby, I'll roll up.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The Patriots do have ties to the South. That is correct. Yeah, you're listening right. This is a cannabis show. That is true. But at the same time, when you have such things, this don't come every day, okay? It don't. That you have so many kids that come from one area. I'm sorry, it's my sports and my roots. And, it, you know, we're going to get to cannabis in a minute. But I have to give props where props is due. And this report is going to come from you from WCNC. And then I got a second follow-up that I'm taking snippets from the Herald here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Rock Hill natives Gilmore and Patterson out of Super Bowl victory win in New England. Now, check this out. For those who don't know who these two individuals are, let me go ahead and give you a break on them. For Stephen Gilmore chasing Super Bowl trophy, which he achieved, he is now an All-Pro defensive back. Now, check that out now. All-Pro defensive back. So, this is an older story, so we're going to be cutting through bits and pieces of it. Like many kids, Stephen Gilmore dreamed of playing professional football. The Rock Hill native is now in his second season with the Patriots. So what does that tell y'all? Bling, bling, y'all. Bling, bling. Stryker say Super Bowl. When I was a kid, I listened to Dream all the time about the NFL, Gilmore said, and that's always been a dream of mine. Truly, it was a dream that Stephen had a young child waking up to his mom, Linda, the oldest of their kids, of Linda and Stephen Gilmore, and their son mentioned in the dream once quietly went to work chasing it. So this is what I'm going to say about this, not going into everything like them. Him and Cornell Patterson. One went to Northwestern High School, which was Cornell Patterson. Stephen Gilmore went to South Point High School, which is right around the corner from where I do my shows at. And let me tell you something. I witnessed both of these young men on the field here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. So it's no doubt in my mind that I knew they would make their careers. But they're going on such names as behind before them as Jadeveon Clowney. Now you think about it. Rock Hill don't even have 1 million people. You listen? Oh, I got your attention now. Yes. So to have those type of eyes for that many people, Google Rock Hill, South Carolina, and pro football players, and you'd be surprised. We have quite a few players, especially that came out of the University of South Carolina. Now they're coming out of Clemson. Going on to bigger and better things in the NFL. So now more than ever, South Carolina needs to get it together with these medical cannabis bills. We currently have a Therapeutic Act of 1980. Please Google it and look it up, because it's very important that people realize we do have a medical bill here, and all it needs to be is enacted. Once House and Congress get their acts together and go ahead and take it off of Schedule 1, that should retroact itself. I don't know. I'm not a law professor, but I'm looking into it. So just keep that in mind. You heard that here on the Wake and Bake Show. Now, talking about CBD for a second. It was an article on WBTV speaking to a doctor, a laboratory, something to that effect. I was half asleep and half woke when I seen the story this morning, to be honest with you. And they said, now, and I quote, that you could test positive on CBD. You know, okay. Anybody know what the percentage of 0.3% THC is? That is a very subminimal amount of cannabis that can be in your system. And that's less than what the government states that's supposed to be, okay? So my question is this. Somebody that tested positive for speeding horse hockey to whoever they took the test to or something, because it just don't jive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be asking some experts myself on this matter. As far as I know of, I don't know anybody personally that used CBD and has came up positive on a drug test. And if you know anybody that would you please have them to hit me up on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. I personally believe it's a scare tactic to drive down sales of CBD products in this area. I'm going to see if I can contact the people that did this report and see if I can get them to come on air and have them to answer a few questions for me, and we prove that test for ourselves. What you think? I think it'll be an excellent idea, personally. So we're going to do just that. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull up some more stories for y'all, and we're going to be right back. You're in tune to the Wake and Bake Show. It is the late edition, the Midday Burn edition. As a matter of fact, we don't do it often, but we're going to have fun with it whilst we can.
Is this the real Is this the cannabis caught on the dry side? Must escape from reality. Just legalize, and I gonna plant my seed.
I'm just a homeboy. Weed is no luxury.
I need a to be here, to be there. Little high, very high.
Everywhere the weed grows, not a really.
Kill the man. Put a blunt against his head. Light the light and now he's dead. Ganja, everybody, is a gift from God. So why go and throw it all away? Ganja, ooh, is meant to make you fly. If I not back again this time tomorrow, pass it on, pass it on. Save me some for later. Too late, the time has come. Getting legal around the world and improving all the time. Goodbye, prohibition. Grass has got to grow. Gotta leave ignorance behind and spread the buzz. Ganja, we all wanna fly. This magical herb should be distributed to all. Puff off a spliff.
Purple Kush, will you make me want to go?
Look at all the lights on, very, very frightening me.
Over,
I'm just a homeboy, nobody stones me.
He's just a homeboy from a dry neighborhood, sparing his grass from this illegality.
Easy plant, easy grow, will you let me grow?
No, we will not let you grow.
Let me grow.
yeah. I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good, sometimes I don't, hey, no. I finesse down Western Road, hey, next. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait, yeah. I make sure that Northside E. And still, bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Yeah. Hey, hey. She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom. I'm sorry. 50 dub, I even got it tatted on me. 81, they'll bring the crashers to the party. And you know me, turn the 02 into the 03, dog. Without 40 Ollie, there be no me. Imagine if I never met the broskies. God's plan, God's plan. I can't do this on my own, hey, nope. Ay. Someone watching it close, yep, yeah, close. I've been me since Scarlet Row, hey, bro, hey. Might go down as G-O-D, yeah, wait. I go hard on Southside G, hey, wait. I make sure that Northside E, yeah. And still. Bad things, it's a lot of bad things that they wishing and wishing and wishing and wishing they wishing on me. Yeah. Yeah. Bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Yeah.
And we're back. You're in tune to the Wake and Bake Show. You can do this here. You can say Alexa. Alexa gonna listen up. You're gonna say iHeartRadio. You're gonna say podcast. You're gonna say Miss Green Jeans, the Wake and Bake Show. You can catch me there anytime. I have shows. I have some short shows. I have some long shows. Most of them try to be as long as possible, but sometimes it is what it is. Check us out on iHeartRadio today. Now, tensions flare in South Carolina State House over proposal to allow liquor sales on Sunday. Now, this is the thing. Before anybody get their panties in a bunch, the reason I'm bringing this up is this. You can hurry up and throw a liquor law ban real quick on this, but I'm going to tell you what the story said, and I'm going to give you my opinion after the fact. Now, I know the story's a little late, but it still has a relevance to about what's going on currently. And this comes out of Columbia by thestate.com. A proposal to allow expanded Sunday liquor sales in 10 tourist heavily SC communities, including Richland and Lexington, sparked tension debate Thursday between evangelists and the state lawmaker who call themselves hypocrites. Judge me not, lest he be judged, said South Carolina House Majority Leader Todd Rutherford, quoting the Bible as he began minutes-long heated response to Republican lawmaker who said South Carolinians don't want to see customers entering the liquor store as they drive home from church. A House Judiciary Committee passed the proposal to allow expanded sales after nearly an hour debate, which State Representative Josh Meeba Craven of Greenwood and SC Baptist Convention Representative Joe Matt described the liquor as a danger to public health and safety. Back when we were going to the mini bottle to the big bottle, we're saying we don't think you ought to drink or either the one of those bottles. Nat told the House panel, but accordingly prefer to build the ban on alcohol sales in South Carolina. The more liquor we serve, the more problems we're going to have. The proposal by the state representative Gary Clary Pickens allows stores to sell liquor on Sundays in 10 counties as long as local leaders and the county voters approve on expanding sales. The 10 counties are Beaufort, Charleston, Florence, Georgetown, Greenville, Horny, that is H-O-R-R-Y, Lexington, Richland, Ardenburg, and unfortunately York County. Now that's where I'm going, this is where I'm finna chime in. If you look at the records, please Google York County, South Carolina, DUI arrest. We have the most DUI arrests in this state. Now, y'all can hurry up and pass a bill like that, but we've been in this fight for cannabis for how many years? Y'all just want people to kill themselves off, if you ask me. Every day I can guarantee you, and y'all done heard me talk about this several times, that I have walked into a convenience store or anything else, and somebody walking by me smelling like a distillery. I mean, now, don't get me wrong. Some people can say I'm a hypocrite, but mine is for pain, and I don't drink. I use medical cannabis. So I guess they can say, well, you're being a hypocrite. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Because the point is this. I've yet to know anybody to die from cannabis. Trust me. I can count on my hands, feet, and somebody else's hands and feet and somebody else's hands and feet on how many people have died from alcohol-related accidents. And 77, which is maybe about 7 minutes away from my location where I'm broadcasting from, is one of the deadliest highways here in South Carolina. It's always accidents happen out there. And over 40% of the time, they're deadly, and 99% of the time, they're alcohol-related. Matter of fact, this past weekend, I seen York County pull over 3 people, and guess what they pulled out? They pulled out a container of alcohol. I'm not trying to down nobody on what they do on their downtown. That's their business. But if you know you're drinking and driving, there's too many things. You have a taxi cab service here. You have Uber and you have Lyft. Or better yet, call a friend. Or better yet, stay your ass home. Because I'm going to tell you right now, if I get hit by a drunk driver here after this bill is passed, not only am I, my insurance company going to sue you, we're going to sue the state. Because the simple fact is this. I think personally you're throwing caution to the wind. And I'm not being bitter about cannabis regulations. I'm being bitter for the fact that you'd rather see people do harm than do good. I'm just saying. So you tell me how you feel about that, ladies and gentlemen. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter under Miss Green Jeans. And if you do Twitter, please make sure you put the one behind it. I'm just saying, don't drink and drive, y'all. Hey, you might hurt somebody you love, or better yet, one of mine. And if you do, I will see you in court. We'll be right back.
Gun in the holster bit, right in the upholstery, somewhere right close to me, just in case the rollers be rolling on the G. My woman keep it in the hosiery. I'm known in my town and on strips where high rollers be. I'm up early where the money folders sipping Folgers be. A country boy chilling in Brooklyn like Lefty spoke for me.
Fuck with us, you fuck with the truth, we speak openly.
Never a rat like Donnie Brasco though, cause ain't no hoe in me.
Notice me, senpai, they cry when I choke the speak. Set this crooked city on fire to light the smokery. Old timer speaker us hushed and touched their rosaries. I lust after greatness, I'm aiming right at his ovaries. Better run from the future, Palooka. You acting like it's safe and the revolution's been. There's liars on the loose if we listen to you. We're the takers of the jewels, never singing a tune in.
My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama.
We'll be right back. doctor tell me I over-medicate. I tell her, holy fuck, Jesus Christ, give me a fucking break. She says, don't curse your mama, goddammit, and do a dinner plate. Damn.
I heard it in Brooklyn where all the sinners stay. You running out of ways to go fuck yourself, I will innovate. The skinnier, shitty grin will disintegrate. Every sickening sentence will cheapen them tricks you venerate. Set the phases to faceplate, incinerate. Run the jewels, run with the board, baby, assimilate.
My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right.
They want us dying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right.
But I ain't crying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right.
You raised a line, mama. I ain't lying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right. I said I'm trying, mama. I said, I'm trying, mama.
And congratulations are in order. Jose Canaway Rosario, congratulations. He made the cut. Super honored to be part of the TEDx Gainesville. Here I come, hear me speak about cannabis, breaking the stigma with art and science. The Cadre Museum for Creativity and Intention. They got limited tickets available. TEDx, Courageous Conversations. Once again, my boy, Jose, congratulations. Also, he is owner of Greenwise TV. So, once again, I am so proud of you. Hashtag Gainesville Green Team. We doing things in 2019, ladies and gentlemen. Gainesville, Florida, if you don't know, is my hometown. And every chance I get, I celebrate the opportunity. Yes, I am a original Florida neighbor. Also, believer of the Gainesville dream. So, hopefully, one day, my dream is to be coming back there and bringing the show to Gainesville. I'm still working on that possibility. So, Jose, thank you so very much and for believing me. And I know you're going to put TEDx on fire, literally, with everything that you bring to the table, my brother from another mother. Congratulations. I am so proud of you. So, guys, y'all know what time it is. It's about that point to go ahead and put that PSA out there to remind people, what are you not supposed to do? Drive and be high.
When you're under the influence of marijuana and you choose to get behind the wheel, you know it's wrong. So if you don't listen to your instincts, think about your fellow passengers. Or think about the other people on the road. Even the unexpected ones. And if you don't think about them,
you'll answer to us. Drive baked, get busted.
Also, congratulations goes to Minorities for Medical Marijuana North Carolina chapter of being a part of a big story in CarolinaCannabisNews.com. They are on a current podcast, CCN Podcast, Episode 16, Sean Tolliver of C-Tracks, MM4, and CLT Normal. By the way, he is a part of Charlotte Normal. Congratulations to that as well, my brother. Hey, like I said, if you haven't checked out Minorities for Medical Marijuana, you need to check us out. We're www.m4united.org. We are a 501c nonprofit organization. Check us out. Become a part. If you're not part of 100%, you're definitely a part of Minority. We'll be back.
Wake up Monday morning and I check my stash. Just some shake, wake and bake on some Moroccan hash. Coffee break, some organic fair trade beans popping. Now I'm awake and it's time to go shopping. Roll to the dispensary, patient of the century. Need a nice sativa that will stimulate me mentally. Buds with sticky density of moderate intensity. Pipe like Sherlock Holmes because this weed is elementary. Welcome friends to the dispensary. Fat discounts when you mention me. Any strain, man, what you want to try? You might walk in, but you're going to fly out. You wanna try out? You might walk in, but you gonna fly out. Breeze through security, get my ID checked. Next to the purple haired girl at the front desk, knows my name cause she sees me on the regular, waves me in, says
please turn off your cellular.
Walls and walls of green buds, jugs full of flour, indicas for indica, couch sativas for the power. Bow to the bartender cause he's paid by the hour, as your concierge, your cannabis with OG Sour. Thinks I'll be a fan of this organic stream with amethyst, but so damn gigantic you can help, we'll call it Maximus. A marijuana analyst, he gives his full analysis of CBD to THC. Somebody give this man a kiss. Welcome friends to the dispensary, fat discounts when you mention me. Any strain, man, what you wanna try out? You might walk in, but you gonna fly out. Welcome friends to the dispensary, fat discounts when you mention me. Any strain, man, what you wanna try out? You might walk in, but you gonna fly out. Next to me in line is a guy named Wesley. Smoke weed every day since back in the 70s. Now he's buying edibles, his wife's on chemotherapy. Her recipe of choice kicks the nausea temporarily. Here in the dispensary, there's something green for every crowd. Fat pre-rolls that will make Bob Marley proud. Shadow wax, resin extract for the vape crowd. Two puffs of that and you'll be walking on a vape cloud. Wait now, don't walk away till you pay now. It's gotta be cash till the banks break the shakedown. Make out with the fat eighth and some papes. How dope, man, let the smoke hit you on the way out.
Welcome friends to the dispensary, fat discounts when you mention me. Any strain, man, what you wanna try out? You might walk in, but you gonna fly out. Welcome friends to the dispensary, fat discounts when you mention me. Any strain, man, what you wanna try out? You might walk in, but you gonna fly out.
Blue green, sour diesel, Girl Scout cookies, green crack, White Widow, and the Bubba, kosher cushies, Northern Lights in next. Got that pineapple express, lemon haze, driven poison, Amy Schumer's train wreck. Skywalker OG, purple haze, race 8, AK-47, got me loading up my vape. Cali Miss, blueberry, triple diesel, golden goat. The dispensary is open and I'm never going home.
And we're back. Hey, I got a story for y'all. Marijuana Business Daily. And thanks for our president, Eric Range of Minorities for Medical Marijuana, for sharing this, because this definitely was under my radar. Hey, that's sometimes I get stories from other people sharing those stories. So, you know, if I see a story out there and I know you, I'm going to let you know. Hey, thank you for that lookout, because I definitely want to be on top of that. Washington Pound is allowing small marijuana growers to sell directly to consumers. This story came out the 24th of January, 2019. And this is by Boss Shermine. I hope I pronounced that name correctly. If I did, please hold it to the head and not to the heart. Washington State will consider allowing small cannabis farmers to sell directly to consumers, similar to what's allowed in wineries, breweries, and distilleries, according to the state's top marijuana regulator. The move, if approved by regulations, would give small growers a financial shot in the arm through increased sales and could spur other states to follow suit. Washington also will be following the lead in a few Canadian provinces allowing licensed producers to sell marijuana to consumers at cultivation facilities. Rick Gunner, director of the Washington State Liquor and Cannabis Board, spoke this week to the Cannabis Collective Conference in Portland, Oregon, was joined by Steve Marks, executive director of the Oregon Liquor Control Commission. Both marijuana czar spoke to coming changes to each state's program in response to ongoing oversupply and issues that is causing problems for the cannabis companies. Gazara Elbuttle, some of the financial difficulties facing small farmers, the lack of vertical integration in the market. Colorado's market is very integrated. For example, if a grower has a retail license, it's allowed to sell products in a store. There's a lot of difficulty in the industry, but we never heard of a consumer complaint about the system we set up here in Washington, Gaza added. Marks said experts more discussion about capping the number of cannabis businesses licensed in Oregon through legislative action. There is a lot of competition. There's a lot of distress, a lot of retail outlets. Low prices, Marks says. Now, let me stop right there. For consumers like myself and so many other people, that works out for a good thing. But you got to think about it. It is cost-consuming to do cannabis on a big scale. But if you got the little small mom-and-pop farmers out there, then, hey, by all means, let them do what they do. You know, I don't see any harm with it. And I think they're coming up with a very good idea, and I hope this sparks on to other municipalities. I shared this story on Twitter. Please check it out. I definitely think it is a must-read for people that's in the cannabis community to say, hey, hold up, wait a minute. They might be on to something. So, hey, it is what it is. So think about that for a second. I'm trying to get back to a different story here real quick. That's going to be the last talk of the day. Where is it at? Okay. I think I talked about that the other day. I think we talked about Tennessee and being legalized. Oh, yeah, we talked about that, too. We talked about Carolina cutting its taxes. So, like I said, did y'all check out the Super Bowl ad? If you didn't check that out, the one that they didn't show, yeah, check that out as well. So, what we gonna do is, since today is Monday, since y'all have had I'm still tired from the Super Bowl last night, I'm not gonna lie. Plus, the fact is, y'all like, why is she got a late show today? After watching the Super Bowl game, I'm going to go check out some friends up the road in Charlotte. Lo and behold, I went out and had a flat tire in my driveway. So, what that means, I had to race and get up this morning before the break of dawn to take my car to get it repaired. So, that is why y'all are experiencing the show later than normal. So, what we're going to do is this. Since we don't have that much news today, we're not unprepared. It's just Monday, and it is what it is. So we're going to go ahead and give y'all this little musical interlude, and we're going to be looking for one more story to share to make sure it's the last talk of the day, so you better believe it's going to be a good one. We'll be right back.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. From a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
You don't own me. You don't own me. but I'm Gerald. Yeah. And I can always have just what I want. She's the baddest, I would love to flaunt. Take her shopping, you know Yves Saint Laurent. But nope, nope, she ain't with it though. All because she got her own though. Boss, boss, if you don't know, she could never ever be a broke hoe.
You don't own me. I'm not just one of your many toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go with other boys. Never stay.
Get bored of basic. No. She's the baddest, straight of vicious. Texting her and asking her if she's alone. And send some pictures. She said no.
What?
Well, goddamn. Damn. She said come over and see it for yourself. Never asking for your help. Independent woman, she ain't for the shelf.
Nah.
She's the one. Smoke with her until the. Stand up until we see the sun. The baddest ever. Swear she do it better than I ever seen it done. Never borrow, she ain't never alone. It's when she told me she ain't never, ever, ever, ever gonna be on. Like me before though.
Easy. And we're back. I got the last talk of the day for you, and it's from therealpharmacy.com. Over 1 million children under the age of 6 are taking psychiatric drugs in America. Let that sink in for a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Psychiatric drug use is on the rise in the U.S. 1 out of every 6 Americans now taking some type of medication in this category. This is a highly concerning given the scary side effects and poor effectiveness of many of these drugs. But one particularly disturbing aspect of this trend that seems to get glossed over, and that is the extremely number of children who are taking such drugs. Mental health watchdog group Citizen Commission on Human Rights is drawing attention to the concentrating fact there's more than 1 million kids younger than 6 in our nation that is currently taking these psychiatric drugs. While half of these children are 4 to 5 years old, it's an incredible 247,804 of them are younger than a year old. That's why babies are being given psychiatric drugs. The number rises for toddlers ages 2 to 3 with 370,778 kids in this category taking psychiatrics overall. Data from the MS Health show that the situation only gets worse as kids older than 4 is 130,340 kids ages 6 to 12 are taking some type of psychiatric drug. You might be forgiven to assume that most of these statistics are made up by kids taking ADHD drugs, given how common approach seems to be nowadays, but it really accounts for the small portion with 1.22 of them younger than the age of a year old and 181,000 ages 4 to 5 are taking ADHD drugs. Now, This is the last talk of the day, ladies and gentlemen. And the reason I brought this up is I have grandchildren in that age. And I'm going to tell you right now, if their mamas come up to me talking about they need no psychiatric drugs, I'm going to ask them, can I see their doctor? Because these drugs have fallen hurting circumstances to a young psychic body and mind. But yet, one is still, they don't want to give these kids cannabis for the same problems they give them these psychiatric drugs. So, something you need to ask, ladies and gentlemen, if you're living in the South, aren't you tired of your kids being drugged up? I'm just saying. I know one thing, it won't go down in my clan. I'm going to tell you that right now. So, you need to think the same way I do. You need to question your doctor if they're talking about putting your babies or your grandbabies on psychiatric medication. Ask them this question. Are yours on that medication? So I got one question for you. Are you awake yet? If not, tune in tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. unless specified. We'll be talking about all this and then more. So I just want y'all to enjoy the rest of your day. I know it's Monday. That's why I'm not trying to bring it too hard. A lot of us is enjoying the Super Bowl win. Some of y'all are still pissed off about the Saints. The season is over. Let's get ready for the next phase of football that's coming up. Yes, we got new football coming in. Steve Spurrier is the coach. I'm really excited about that. And I'm going to see if I can get an interview with some of the coaches or teammates down there and see what their policies is on this new football league that's opening up. Can they use cannabis? I know y'all want to know. I do too. So until then, y'all have a blessed day. Stay safe and stay well. And keep being green.
One big body girl, me a wipe and baka. Two bag of weed, some papers and grab a make we get high. Go and build your spliff bonnets and push it into the sky. We get high. We get high. We get high, yeah, yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh. So come follow me. I make the girl them a pray. No fire trap, but that no worry will. Make them know so we no stall out. And the shot of them they all bout. Guinness a piece of me under my senses. And you know me bunny plenty. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Me bunny plenty, yeah, yeah. One big body girl me a wife and baka. Two bag of weed, some papers and grab a make we get high. One build a split bonnet and push it into the sky. We get high. We get high. We get high, yeah, yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh. So come follow me. Cause we up on the best trees. And we know such as a blessed way. So no matter how them fight it, anywhere with them we light it. Guinness a bit of me under my senses. And the girl them they are plenty. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Them they are plenty, yeah, yeah. One big body girl me a white bambaka. Two baka with some papers and grab a make we get high. Build a split bonnet and push it into the sky. We get high. We get high. We get high, yeah, yeah. Ain't nobody trying to leave until we die, yeah, 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 yeah. We're not gonna live here tonight. So all I drink and I split and I get tight till the sunrise. Yeah, 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 yeah. Until the sunrise, we get high. One big body girl, me a wine from baka. Two baka with some papers and grab a make we get high. One
bill, just flip on it and push it in the sky. We get high. We get high. We get high, yeah, yeah. Ooh. So come follow me. Run, come follow me. Yeah, nobody trying to leave until we tie tonight. No fuss, no fight. We come get high.
Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of
I put it.
looking at me when I'm walking past the mirror. Don't you worry about doing what you're gonna do. I'm a lady, so I must stay fast. Gotta keep it high, keep it together. If I want to get better, I won't change.
Symbolizes the bottom, we at the top. And Pimp C, that last year was a shot. And my flow is so tip-top notch, cause I'm on my raps like a hip-hop cop. Why, oh, why, my, oh, my, Miss Mary J, I am so obliged for you to involve, please, babe. I told my mom and she went crazy. She said, son, that's a good look for you. And she wanted me to let you know that she would cook for you. But back to the subject, something you could dance to. Slizzy is a vandal, Wizzy is a candle. And we are crack, smack, and never whack like I never had a caddy. I would never laugh, and I would never lie. I would never say never, would I ever say never, say never, cause I never gave up. Whatever, it's whatever. I be with bad guys and good fellas. Yeah, you're jealous, and we're not .com. Email us.
I won't change my life.